In this screencast, I'm going to discuss how the apparent activation energy, which means if we measure the log of the experimental rate constant versus inverse temperature, how that apparent activation energy depends on the activation energy of the reaction rate constant and on the heats of adsorption for the reactants and or products or even other components that are present. And also, as a result, it means this does not have to be a straight line, and the apparent activation energy can change with temperature. So let's look at a simple example in which A plus B is reacting to products. And we're going to assume that the product concentration, so this is, we're going to assume, is a low concentration, just to simplify a bit the calculations and make it a little easier to see the behavior that we're interested in. So if we had the type of reaction rate expression that we see for Langmuir-Hinshelwood mechanisms, we'd have a rate that's proportional to a rate constant, and then the adsorption equilibrium constants for A and B, the pressure of A and the pressure of B. And in the denominator, we have a term that has adsorption equilibrium constants for A and B and the pressures for A and B squared. So depending on which regime of coverage on the surface, because this is results from saying we have a rate constant times the coverage of A, the fractional coverage, and the fractional coverage of B. So let's look at some limiting cases. So we're going to assume that A is weakly adsorbed relative to B, meaning the coverage of A on the surface is low and B is strongly adsorbed, so its coverage on the surface is high. So this means that we're assuming KB times the pressure B is significantly greater than KA times the pressure of A. KB times the pressure B is also greater than 1. So we're going to simplify the rate expression. So it means what I've done is say this term and this term is small in the denominator. So the denominator just becomes KB squared pressure B squared, which simplifies then to this form that we see here. Now, each of these terms have a temperature dependence, and therefore they're going to affect the apparent activation energy. If we look at this rate as being K experimental, pressure of A, the pressure of B to the minus 1 over some temperature regime where the coverage of B is much higher than A and high enough that we can drop the term here in the rate expression. So the rate constant of the reaction is going to have a temperature dependence where it exponentially depends on the activation energy for the reaction. So this is the activation energy for the surface reaction. And then the adsorption equilibrium constants, both K and KB, are going to have a temperature dependence. And that is going to depend on the heat of adsorption. So we use the notation here to make it easier to follow that lambda is a positive number. In other words, lambda A is minus delta H of A for adsorption. So that lambda of A is greater than 0 because almost all adsorption is exothermic, meaning this term is negative. So if we substitute these three expressions into our rate expression, and this rate we can look at as the apparent rate constant, so I'll call this A0 apparent e to the minus e apparent over RT, again, pressure of A and pressure B. So we can look at the temperature dependence terms, which means we can say this term is equal to the product of these three terms, and therefore relate the apparent activation energy, so minus E apparent, is going to be equal to the activation energy for the surface reaction, plus the heat of adsorption for A, minus the heat of adsorption for B. So then you can see for our expression for apparent activation energy, it can be less than the surface reaction activation energy, E, or it even could be greater, depends on the relative values of these two. Now, we said that B is strongly adsorbed relative to A, so that would mean the heat of adsorption for B is greater than heat of adsorption A. So what we then would expect is that E apparent is going to be greater than surface reaction activation energy. Now we can certainly imagine other possibilities. We could have both A and B being weakly adsorbed so that the denominator, look back at our original ray expression, so that 1 in denominator here is large relative to the other two terms. And then our rate expression, so I've just done the same type substitution, determine the apparent activation energy and how it relates to heats of adsorption and the surface reaction activation energy. And now we can see that in this case, E apparent is going to be less than E. Remember, you see if adsorption values are both positive numbers, so the net effect is just subtracting a value from the surface reaction activation energy. So what this means physically is that as we raise the temperature, so as temperature increases, the rate constant for the reaction increases, but the coverages of A and of B can decrease, and depending on the relative values, it determines now how the reaction rate depends on temperature for different possibilities, of which we've shown a couple in this screencast. But there's a competition where coverage decreasing causes the rate to decrease, rate constant increasing causes the rate to increase. Indeed, it's possible in some cases, as we raise the temperature, the rate would go through a maximum because that coverage decrease could dominate. Namely, these two terms could be large enough to make the apparent activation energy negative.